And back to the campaign and that very closely watched race in Nevada. Judy Woodruff reports, part of our Vote 2010 coverage.
At night, the dizzying lights of Las Vegas and its string of casinos are as bright as they ever were. The gambling capital of the U.S. remains a draw for anyone looking for adult fun. But daylight reveals just how hard the recession has hit the largest city in what was the fastest growing state in the country for two decades running. Political analyst John Ralston.
We are the unemployment capital of America. It's going to get to 15% here, perhaps. We have the highest foreclosure rate in America. This was the classic boom economy that's now gone bust, and it's hurt a lot of people.
At times like these, all politicians seeking re-election would expect voter frustration and even anger. But it's a double whammy for Nevada's senior U.S. Senator Harry Reid, who also happens to be the Senate's highest-ranking Democrat.
Harry Reid has become a Washington power broker. He no longer is there representing the state of Nevada. I mean, he pretty much does the heavy lifting for the president. The president creates the programs. Harry Reid executes the programs.
Thanks for coming out Saturday morning.
Tea Party activist and newly elected Republican Party leader here, Frank Ricotta, capsulizes what motivated him and others who had never been active in politics before to rise up and oppose Reid now and down the road, President Obama.
This government far overreaches its authority, and so we need to start at the local level to elect conservative candidates to support our Constitution and make sure we ensure our freedoms.
Ricotta and other Tea Party enthusiasts found their choice to beat Reid in a former state assemblywoman, Sharron Angle, who had been seen as occupying the political fringes, but in the angry atmosphere of 2010 has found support. With his poll ratings hitting new lows and some ready to write him off, Reid and his allies were watching closely last June when Angle, seen as the weaker GOP candidate, was chosen.
Thank you all. Thank you all, Nevada patriots.
Reid quickly launched a barrage of critical TV spots, singling out statements Angle has made over abolishing Social Security, doing away with the U.S. Department of Education, and approving a nuclear waste facility in Nevada.
Sharron Angle wants to bring all 5 million pounds here for reprocessing in Nevada. But one nuclear spill could endanger our families and kill Las Vegas tourism forever.
Soon, polls showed the attacks were doing their job. Angle's rating started to drop. Today, 4 months and millions of dollars worth of negative advertising later, many from outside political organizations, the race is a dead heat.
Boomer!
Voters are energized, some in organized Tea Party meetings like this one in Mesquite, Nevada. Rick Crane founded the Tea Party group here.
I think it's the most important election of my life. That, in that, if we don't change, if Mr. Reid goes back to Washington, then the change that is happening is kind of overtaking the country and moving it to the left so strongly will be out of our control.
Candidly, we got to talk about city center.
Meanwhile, Reid's supporters, like powerful Culinary Workers Union head D. Taylor, argue Reid has done everything he could to create and preserve jobs and help the unemployed.
When people are laid off and having a tough go, the idea that you would not extend unemployment benefits, which Angle said she would not have done, is, in my opinion, unconscionable and, frankly, immoral.
And longtime GOP consultant Sig Rogish, who advised Presidents Reagan and George H.W. Bush, broke ranks with his party because he says no one has done more for Nevada than Harry Reid. And because of what he calls Angle's extreme positions, which he says are unacceptable to national Republican leaders.
They cannot stand side by side with someone who wants to eliminate Social Security. The party can't accept that kind of thought process, or someone who wants to eliminate entirely all mandates for insurance companies. Why have insurance?
We tried it Harry Reid's way, and it didn't work.
For her part, Angle has been airing anti-Reid TV spots like this one.
Want to know just how out of touch Harry Reid is? Spending $787 billion on a stimulus that failed is a start. Or Reid voting to give illegal aliens special tax breaks and Social Security benefits is another big clue. But here's the kicker. Reid actually voted to use taxpayer dollars to pay for Viagra, for convicted child molesters and sex offenders. What else could you ever need to know about Harry Reid?
The heavily negative tone of the spots and the fact that they've been blanketing TV has left many Nevada voters with a bad taste in their mouths.
I don't want to vote simply because of all of the bashing that's going on.
But when pressed, voters confirm the ad's messages are coming through.
I think that honestly it's unbelievable that one party thinks that another party could be responsible for the economic situation with the housing when this problem exists in every city and state.
As Election Day draws closer, Reid is holding rallies with groups that are working to get out his vote, like Latinos, and this one for unions aimed at senior citizens.
As long as I am a member of the United States Senate, no one will mess with Social Security.
Afterward, Reid acknowledged she's up against a tough political climate, but said Angle can't run away from what he says are unacceptable positions she's taken.
People of Nevada aren't stupid. I mean, they know what this woman has stood for, not for a few weeks, not for a few months, but years.
I'm struck by how many people we see in the polls hold you in disfavor. Why are they holding you responsible for this?
Well, they're holding a number of people, me and Obama, principally, even though anyone logically understands that we had nothing to do with creating the problems. They were there when the new Congress started.
We were in Nevada for 4 days and attended two Reid rallies, but locating an Angle rally was more difficult.
One of the earmarks of this campaign is how hard it is to talk to or even find Sharron Angle. After scores of emails and dozens of phone calls, our request for an interview was denied. It was only by talking to a Tea Party activist that we were able to find out she's due to speak at this hotel.
After we arrived here and saw the no press sign, her campaign said she wasn't coming. The one debate that Angle agreed to on Las Vegas PBS, aired statewide, gave her a chance to go after Reid face to face, and she did.
Man up, Harry Reid.
But it also put her on the spot about previous positions she's taken.
Before the primary, you used the word privatized, and now you use the word personalized. Why did you change your position on Social Security?
Well, because of the idea that personalized covers both private and public.
Now, she talks about and has for years talked about getting rid of Social Security, for years. Now she's trying to change her tune.
With early voting underway and only 15 days left, both sides are pushing to get supporters to the polls. And both sides have advantages. For Reid, more registered Democrats in Nevada, a well-organized Democratic ground game, and a divided GOP that has dozens of state Republican officials defecting to support him rather than the Tea Party-backed Angle. Yeah. University of Nevada, Las Vegas professor David Damore.
You know, the insider scoop is that Angle has really made no attempts to sort of reach out to establishment Republicans there. Harry Reid has done a nice job creating his Republicans for Reid. Now, Sharron Angle sort of wears that to some degree as a badge of honor, because much as most of the Tea Parties, they're not only just fighting the Democrats, but they're also fighting the Republican establishment. So she tries to spin that in her favor. But at the end of the day, it's made it much more difficult for her to raise money in state.
Much of the $14 million raised by Angle in the last quarter came from out of state. But into the home stretch, both have about the same amount on hand. For Angle, the advantage is anger over the economy and the enthusiasm of the right.
So the central question then is the enthusiasm gap that exists between the Republicans and the Democrats versus this Democratic turnout machine. Can they hold their registration advantage, which is 5 points? Can they not lose too much of it on Election Day?
One other wild card is the Nevada ballot, which includes lines not only for minority parties, but also for none of the above. David Damore says with both candidates carrying such high negatives, this could make a difference.
It helps Harry Reid, right, in the sense that it gives Republicans who maybe can't vote for Harry Reid but don't really cotton with Sharron Angle, that it gives them an out.
But that's a guessing game. Much of the electorate is expected to vote early. Turnout for the first couple of days is described as average.
Our Vote 2010 coverage continues later this week with a report from Battleground State, Ohio, on high unemployment and disappearing jobs.